here in Orland Belk Stadium. Ryan Brown on the field with Wingate head coach Joe Reich after the Bulldogs blow out Lenoir Ryan 49-6. A total domination from this Wingate football team. And coach, he scored a lot of points this year, but that felt like just as flush and perfect as the offense could be at times out there. Big plays, long drives. That was just an epic offensive performance.
It was a really nice performance. You know, to be able to hit a few big plays like that in the run game, in the pass game, that was about as good as an offensive performance as we put in for a long time. So it was nice to see. You know, defensively, we put our backs against the wall a number of times by just having some stupid penalties on some touchdowns. But once we, you know, and our defense just kind of stepped up and said, okay, well, here we go. You know, and they it was great to see in the red zone in particular that we just really stepped up defensively. I thought that was a good win for us.
Yeah, LR has really struggled in the red zone this year, but they were just trying to find any way to get in there. You guys dominate that area. If they're in there five times, they get two field goals. What makes the team successful in that situation? What can you do to make the other side difficult?
Sure. I think when you get in the red zone, the passing game gets kind of crunched down a little bit. And you can't spread it out as much, and you've got to rely a little bit on your power game. And I think that's why we've been a little more successful on offense for the first half of the season, because we're a little bit more of a power running team right now. So, you know, they're a little bit more of a side-to-side flex team, you know, spread team right now, which is just who they are right now as they kind of recruit for their program. I think for us, when we're kind of getting compacted like that, you know, our defense is able to play the run a lot more and kind of load up on the run. And I think that's where we had a big advantage against them today, just in the overall run game. Defensively, we just felt like we could dominate there. So when you're getting that in the red zone and it condenses the passing game down, it just makes the run game that much more important.
Three touchdown runs over 50 yards today. Two 100-yard backs, Dom and Blake Hayes, both get 100 yards. Boy, that offensive line is feeling pretty good this time of year. I mean, did you see this coming, or they just had another great day?
They just had a great day. That, you know, I'll say this: Greg Zier, our line coach, is as good a young coach as I know. I mean, the guy does a great job. He really is just a phenomenal young coach, and that group of offensive linemen is extremely hard working. You know, starting with Daniel Owens, Cabell Cantrell, you know, Austin May. That older group of guys has really kind of taken some of the younger guys under the wing. You know, John Black and Connor Barron Eunice. And Strickland, those guys, the younger guys have kind of learned from the older guys, and they're just a good, hard-working bunch. At the beginning of the year, you know, we just weren't sure what we had offensive line-wise, and a couple of those, you know, John Black is a redshirt freshman, and the two, Barron Eunice and Strickland as a true freshman, those guys have really stepped up and played well to accentuate some of those upperclassmen. So, and then Jake Jensen playing tight end, doing a great job for us. He's a very multiple guy. You know, we can put him attached and blocked down as tight end. We can put him in the backfield as a fullback. He's kind of multidimensional, and that's really helped us, I think, in defending us. It makes it tough to kind of defend us because you're not sure where he's going to line up. So I think that combination of stuff has been pretty good for us. And like I said, Kyle throwing it just enough to kind of keep people off our backs. This was an important day today for us because we felt like we needed to be able to do that, throw the ball to say, hey, we can do this. It's not like we've forgotten about it, and because we're going to need to keep people out of the box and do what we need to do.
Coach, finally 6-1 for the second straight year, heading into a really, really tough stretch, 3 out of 4 on the road. Right. Will there be any past message about the past, or is this 2016?
You know, we've already hit that. We've been saying since the beginning of the year we need to finish strong, you know, be a second-half team in games, be a second-half team in the year. So that's not anything they haven't heard already. They've heard it from me. They've heard it from the other coaches. They've said it amongst themselves. So every time we win this game, they're always celebrating, but there's always kind of that, okay, let's get to let's get to where we were last year, and let's take it from there. And now we're there. So now it's back on the road, going up to Tennessee, and you know, and that'll be a good trip for, you know, a good test for us going up there. I don't know how they did today, but you know, that'll be a good test for us.
Coach, we appreciate your time as always. Congratulations.
Great, thanks.